When we click on a 3D shape, the 3D settings toolbar appears. There is something like that for 3D bodies. It's a dialog box called 3D effects. To turn on the 3D effects, our first thought is to go into View, Toolbars, but we don't see any 3D effects. That's because it's a dialog box and not a toolbar. To add it to one of our toolbars, I'm coming down to Customize, and we're already in the Toolbars tab. So I'm coming over to Toolbars, and I'm going to select this TFCG that we created early on in this video tutorial series. Here's my current commands. I want to add one, so I'm clicking Add. I'm going to come over to the category of Options, and it's this one up on the top, and it's already selected. I'm going to click Add and Close. And we see it's going to add it between Print and Circle Arc. I want it to the far left, so I'm going to click this arrow up. Clicking OK. And we see that it's on our TFCG toolbar. I've added a new page and placed some shapes on this page. Now I'm going to turn on my 3D effects just by clicking on it. And we're going to notice that on the bottom of all the pages, it's going to have these three buttons. There's five tabs at the top. We got geometry, shading, illumination, textures, and material. And all of them have these same three buttons. These first two are inactive. To make them active, I need to select an object. Once I've selected it, they're active, and I can click on it. It says Convert to 3D. And we see that this top one does the same thing as Modify, Convert to 3D. Selecting our other object and going over to Convert to Lathe Object, we see that that does the same thing as Modify, Convert to 3D Rotation Object. And this third one turns our perspective on off. Let me select the square, make this a little larger, maybe rotate it a little bit so we can get a better look at things. Now I'm clicking the perspective on off button. And we've got a little preview window. We see a little change in there, but no change on our picture. That's because I didn't click the assign button. Now I can see I turned the perspective off. To turn it back on, I click on it, and I need to click on the assign button again. And we have the perspective back. The only thing unusual about these three buttons was the first two, we did not have to click on the assign button for them to take effect on our object. But the perspective on off, we did need to click on the assign button before that effect would be applied to our shape. Now we want to look at these rounded edges. To save time, I've already inserted one of each of the five variations for our 3D objects and tested the rounded edges and found that it only works on variation one. So let's take a look at variation one. Right now, the rounded edges are set at 0. Let's try 20%. Now I've got to click the assign button before anything will happen. And we see that it rounds those edges. If I want to exaggerate the point a little more, I'll take this up to 50%. Now it's really obvious what's going on. But I like them closer to maybe 10%. So I'm going to change that back to 10% and leave it at that. This next one, scaled depth, this works on all five variations, but we're going to split them up into two groups. We've got our extrusions, which are variations 1, 4, and 5, and then we've got our rotation objects, which are 2 and 3. Let's look at our variation 1. Now, I've changed the scale depth down to 0. If I change that back to 100%, we see that we've got a cylinder with two ends that are even. So when I made it 0%, that came down to a point. So one of the ends changed, the other one didn't. Now if I make this larger than 100%, maybe we'll make it 200%, we think that this bottom should get twice as wide. And we're right. I'm going to change this back down to 0. And the same thing worked with variation 4. In variation 5, you can see I only took it to 40% instead of 0%. Now let's take a look at these rotation objects. And remember how I made these. I clicked on a rectangle, and then I clicked on the convert to lathe object. What it did was it took our single shape and made 360 little shapes going all the way around the same height. This time we want to say we're going to start with a certain height, and our ending shape is going to be, we can make this 0. So it makes shapes and gets smaller each time it goes around. To emphasize this point, let's insert another slide. On this slide, I'm going to insert a curve. Actually, it's going to be a straight line, a polygon. I'm going to make this line a little thicker and change the color to something bright like yellow so it stands out a little more on the video. Now I'm going to click the convert to lathe object, and we've got a cone. Now it looks like a portion of this cone cannot be seen, so we're going to skip ahead into the normals and just click on this double-sided. We'll explain what it means later, but we'll be able to see the effect once I click assign. And now we can see our complete object. Now what we were going to do was make our scale depth down to 0. So the first line is 100%, the last line is 0. So it starts at 100% and makes lines that get smaller and smaller all the way till they get around and down to the 0%. And if you wanted to make this maybe 50%, it's thicker, 25, and we'll take that back down to 0. The next thing we're going to look at is this rotation angle, and that only works with variations 2 and 3. And we can see that if I click on one, I've changed the rotation to 270 instead of 360. And I can change this again to 180. And when I click assign, it should turn into a half of cylinder instead of 3/4, which it does. If we want to have some fun with this rotation angle, if we come back to our previous shape, and let's make this a little bigger. Now if we change this instead of 360, make this 270 degrees, we see that it doesn't come all the way around in touch. It gives us a little space in between. The last thing we're going to look at in this video is the depth. And we'll notice that that only works with the extruded objects, the variations 1, 4, and 5. So let's select 1. That one now has a depth of 2. Let's change that to 1. And we should see that change to about half its height, which it does. I'll change it back to 2. Now coming down to the 3D shapes, it works a little differently. When I change this depth from 0.39 to 2, we'll notice it does get longer, but it got smaller as well. And the same one with our font work. And that's just the letter O from a font work to create that cylinder. I'm going to change that to 2.5. And we'll see that gets a little smaller, but longer. So it doesn't work exactly the same way with the 3D objects as it does with the 3D shapes.